is, looking at it closely, how important is branding to sports in Nigeria? Let's start from the point.
I think that branding is important to everything that you do in life, right? It's all about perception, management. It's all about when you position yourself, your image, if it's your managing a personal brand or an organization, you know, or a corporate entity before its various stakeholders, right? And how do they perceive and everything from what you get in terms of customer loyalty to investor loyalty to general public perception is the right from how you manage your brand. Having said that, it means that it's extremely crucial for even a dilapidated and struggling infrastructure like football or like sports in Nigeria as a whole. It is imperative that we manage our image and perception to be able to attract the quality funding that is required to take the sports to the level it should be, sports generally, you know, to the level it should be. And, you know, we've seen it done in several countries internationally where they have elevated, you know, the standards of the game from what they used to be in previous years to standards that investors can then come in or sponsors can then come in to find it attractive, right? So we need to go back to the fundamentals. We need to go back to the rudiments and say, what is the 101 of branding and how do we apply it in sports in Nigeria? You know, one of the things that we preach very strongly here at Zenera Consulting and having, you know, consulting to some sponsors who are interested in, you know, properties and assets like sports is it has to be from inside out. It's not a whitewashing, you know, affair. You have to go back and fix the integrity of whatever it is that you're presenting or you want to brand in itself, right? It's what we call ethical branding. You go back again and fix it such that the perception that you create externally will resonate and be consistent with what the reality is, you know, and not just, you know, you're paying lip service for it. So that's where we need to go back to fundamentally in our sports in Nigeria today, even though we're just joking.
How would you rebut, okay, how would you rate that? How would you rate them? From a scale of 1 to 10, sort of 0.
Because you can have branding gotten right without having tools. You can have branding gotten right without having tools, right? It follows results, it follows where you go, effort of branding work, right? And Nigeria today, we don't have any results. So what are we talking about? Do you understand? We went to the London Olympics, we won nothing. You know, we went to Rio 2016, we're just fortunate, you know, to get a bronze medal. I get what I'm saying. You know, look at the results at 2012 we're in London. What do we have for it? Look at all the walk-ups and all that we struggle and get it. It is always with prayers and fasting and commentating, you know. This is the first time ever that we'll be in a comfortable, in a long term rather, that will be in a comfortable place leading up to the World Cup. The first time in my own memory, recent memory, so maybe in USA 94, in the days of Western Hour, you know, whatever. But just imagine, the guy that was giving birth to 1994, today is about 23 years old.
Yeah, he
doesn't know what you're talking about. So what I'm saying is that in the generation that we're dealing with right now, this is the first time we'll be comfortable saying we are likely to qualify. You know, and that's because you have a sponsor for the first time in ITO who's coming to say, no, let's fix, you know, basic things like the salaries of coaches and the people who are sweating and working hard to get things done. If you look at it, how many people, all the coaches from the days of the league, they go and check and see how much you are older. And some people have died, Shoaibu and the rest of them, you know, still being old. Their estates have still been old up to today. Do you understand? So the cashier, I don't know, look at the issues. You know, so we need to go back and get it right. The results are not good. Everybody talks about football. How many sporting events are there in the world? Go to the Olympics, over 100, right? At best, we go and participate in just a couple. Do you understand? Is that good enough? Nigeria has close to 180 million people. Do you understand? You know, we shouldn't be at this level at all. And we need to declare a national emergency in sports. Because until we do that, it will not hit us that we have a crisis. And one of the things that we fail to understand and appreciate is that we think that sports is what you do as an afterthought. It's what you do when everything else is well. Then you pay attention to say, what's going on you know, with sports and investment. That is very wrong. Sports is not what you do as an afterthought. Activity is what you bring to the forefront and use it as a unifying factor. Nigeria has issues today. We're talking about restructuring, we're talking about, you know, people wanting to go their separate ways, decision and all of that crisis there, you know, the military is in Abia right now and all of that because of resistivity and the rest of it. What we are failing to do is that when you win a match, have you seen the celebrations? Do we have, you know, different celebrations for the Hausas and the Igbos and the Yorubas when we take to the streets with rejoicing and go to the pubs, you know, and people are celebrating and throwing parties? You have separate parties for different ethnic groups. Never. Go and check it. The times that we're doing very well with sports and everything has been the times that we've stayed together as united as ever. When you then do that and we're together as one country, that's where you can be prosperous, that's where you can be thinking of what is the GDP, what are we in recession technically, or are we in, you know, the downturn, or is it a depression? Do you understand what I'm saying? All those financial indicators then become relevant when you are first and foremost one country. And sports is something that can deliver it for you. So why don't we prioritize it? You know, sometimes it begs, you know, answers.
All right, now, you consult for ITO, who have actually changed the face of sports in Nigeria.
Yes.
All right, so give us an inside perspective. What do they see in football? Because you've said that if you were to label and actually if you were to rates are at sports ground in Nigeria, especially when you're football, one of them, in sub-zero. So what do they see that decided that you, what advice do you give to them that said it has to be that invest in football and you might actually get something out of it?
See, you know, the reason why I still came into football, in my own opinion, is multiple factors. But the primary thing is the desire to give back to a nation. Desire to see that something very critical as sports that has been a unifying factor and has done this country so much good is under so much dilapidation and is under complete decay and is an embarrassment to us as a nation internationally. So ITO being an international brand is, you know, has access to various markets all over the world, and everywhere we go, something as basic as sporting factor that has been turned into brands in various nations, in the UK, in Spain, in Italy, in France. Do you understand? They've been able to use sports to galvanize various sectors of their own existence. And then you come to Nigeria, and then something that we should have been a no-brainer, we are getting embarrassed all the time. So it's purely from a corporate social investment and sustainability point of view. That's what, you know, ITO looked at it and said, this is one area we can help. This is one area that, you know, there's so much gap in the country, and our intervention is dearly required. You know, so when the NFF, you know, made their presentations, you know, to them, you already resonated with this sort of ideas that ITO had, and, you know, some of the strategy sessions that have taking place in terms of, you know, how do we support nation building, how do you support national development, how do we support, you know, this country in you know, areas that will resonate with the most number of people, where people will feel the impact, you know, the most. So those were the things that happened. And I must give it also, you know, to the present NFF. They did a good job of packaging it, which is where branding comes in. You know, articulating their presentations and saying these are the arguments, these are the merits of getting involved. You know, this is what you get back as a corporate entity in terms of publicity and branding, you know, and ROI. And, you know, this is what we will do in return. Because one of the things that the client was very particular about was to say that the monies that would be advanced would be judicially administered.
You know, so financial derivatives came on board to make sure that, you know, they would adjudicate properly in that process and superintend, you know, the disbursements on the funds and make sure that those was those were well done. You know, so for the first time we're seeing, you know, a lot of changes. We're seeing a lot of motivation in the dressing room and on the pitch as well. You know, because some of the conversations that used to cause the friction have been, are now things of the past in terms of, oh, our players, allowances paid, our coaches, you know, paid. You know, we've seen times where people, you know, even players have threatened industrial actions, you know, before matches, you know, but all of that, you know, it's also showing in the results, you know, like I tell you, when you get your branding right, results follow, you know, and now everybody is happy for the first time. We've all chilled our bottles of champagne, ready to pop them, you know, when Nigeria qualifies.
All right, okay, that's a beautiful one. And let me just, not to digress, but it's good we actually mentioned this. I want to take this, as a consultant to my team, and certainly what I've heard, what has been making rounds in the newspapers and TVs, everybody carrying that, the team was pulled out.
Absolutely not. There's no truism to it. Aichi is committed irrevocably to 5 years sponsorship, you know, as the optimum support partner of the NFF. We've gone ahead to even take on the Federation's Cup sponsorship. It's now rebranded as ITO Cup, you know, and we are even having discussions right now with NFF to even extend the properties and the assets that we acquire, you know, in terms of, you know, support. So, you know, it is a long journey, you know, and understandably sometimes at the beginning, you know, people who don't understand the dynamics of, you know, the relationship may have comments to pass, you know, like what happened, you know, last week. But the truth is that, you know, it's not for the short term. The commitment is for 5 years. And, you know, even at that, ITO has the right of first refusal in terms of continuing the sponsorship. So, ITO has issued a statement immediately saying, you know, that's not correct, that's not the case. The commitment is for the long term, and there's no consideration for review right now.
From general consultant, you're looking at other sports. What do you advise other sports to do if they are to actually see this kind of goodwill and also sponsorship that can take their own sports from where they are right now to where they want to be? It will be
branding properly. In fact, many of them don't even have brands to be rebranded. It's packaging the sports in an attractive manner. So the first question you ask is, what do I do differently? How do I get into the mind of the investor or the sponsor? You can't sit down and do the things that you've done all over the years and expect a different result. That would be insanity. You ask yourself and say, hey, how do these guys think? Which is where, you know, consultants, you know, and firms like Zonera, you know, come in. How do these guys think? What will resonate with them? What do they want to hear? They are investors, they are capitalists, they are corporate entities, they are not NGOs, right? How are they wired? Even when they're doing their corporate social investments, what are the things that they find attractive? Now, when you have established that, then you work backwards to start to, you know, present yourself in a way that they will find irresistible, right? So you come and say, this is it. I'm giving you this value. There's no way, you know, you can get it wrong. And be prepared in the first instance to give them mouth-watering, you know, attractions that they cannot refuse, so that you get them, you know, because right now we're jump-starting the system. We are coming, somebody who's gone comatose, you're trying to, you know, give electric shocks to start the heart again. That's where most of these sporting activities are. That's one. And I mentioned something about branding, which is going back to do things properly. Let it be in your DNA. Don't perception of being good or, you know, carrying yourself in a particular way that make people applaud you shouldn't be the things that you do ad hoc. Shouldn't be the things you say that you do. It should be who you are. Do you understand? So when you start to have, you know, teams who are trying to get into the next division, like we saw in 2013, you know, with with Plateau United feeder and police machine, scored 79 goals and 69 goals in one in second half. They scored 72 goals in one half. Do you understand what I'm saying? And then you want a sponsor to come and be a part of that. That's a charade. That's not going to happen. If I was advising any client, you would not put your money on those kind of, you know, facade. The other side. So we need to bring integrity back into those sports, you know, in the first instance, you know, and fix the fundamentals of other things that we need to do to position it like others have done. Do you understand? You know, so too much interference, you know, by, you know, government officials, they wanting to go on, you know. There are games that we've been that government officials, the number of government officials that went to those games exceeded the players themselves. Don't take my words for it, go and check. Especially in a lot of other sports. Go and check. You have, you know, 2-3 people who are going to represent Nigeria, and you have 10-12 government officials who are following them. How is that going to work? Who are you developing? What is your grassroots development policy? Where are you starting from? You know, those are the questions that the investors want to hear, because it's all about sustainability, right? We want to make sure that in years after, generations after, that game would still continue, you know, to make us proud. So many of the clients that we represent would not get into any activity if you can't say that in 50 years' time it's going to subsist, right? So you have to come up with your, you know, your plan to say, this is how I'm going to support this game, this is what I'm going to do, this is the consistency that I'm going to bring in from the get-go. And then when you're able to marshal all those thoughts very articulately, right, people are looking for value. Corporate people employ us to make sure that we spot those, you know, value additions, you know, for their brands. So when you see that and you recognize that, it will be foolhardy not to invest in it. It's very simple.
Yes.
The internet is replete with, you know, ideas about how to do, you know, how to package yourself, how to do things properly, you know. And many of these things are not as expensive as we thought. They have employees in those organizations. Why don't you employ the right, you know, fit for purpose, you know, person to do, you know, the job? So they have a retinue of employees and staff who, you know, just go to any ministry or any department or agency of government that cater for this sporting activity, and you see loads of people there, right? These are people who should be able to champion this thing just by doing your own job. Not more than that, just do your job properly, that's all. Do you understand? But the system is so abhorrent to even saying common sense that when people come and then they start to galvanize for those changes, right, the system stigmatizes them. It doesn't show that we are ready at all. Do you understand what I'm saying? You know, I've heard of, you know, people who have come with so many reformations and have announced them. I've had the misfortune to announce them before entrenching themselves in those ministries, and they were booted out within weeks. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So it's ownership and leadership. How hungry are we for these things? Are we really paying lip service to, you know, our desire for rebranding and for change? Or are we truly committed to it?